In this video, we'll cover the basics for using the record functionality within ScopeBox. Any source that's being brought into ScopeBox can be recorded, either in its raw native format like uncompressed or HDV, or it can be converted into another format during the record for easier editing later on. To begin with, I've added an HDV source, and I'm going to set it to convert into another format. To access these settings, I'll click on the arrow in the lower left corner of the screen. This reveals the clip list and the recorder. The recorder is this bar towards the middle of the window. If I click on it to highlight, I'm going to get a variety of options related to this recorder. I can set the folder that I'd like to store my files in, or I can go into the preferences and set the default. I can use the lock to camera button with some cameras to control ScopeBox's recording from the record button on the camera. The preset duration functionality is part of our live edit feature. This is a pretty complicated advanced feature, so check the manual for full details on that. And then I can click the box for transcoding. This is how I'm going to convert from my HDV source into my ProRes destination. I'll click on the format dropdown and choose ProRes LT. As soon as I select this, ScopeBox is going to begin transcoding behind the scenes. So all of my incoming video is being converted into this ProRes format. In addition to adjusting settings, I can add a name and other metadata about this recording. So I'll click over into the name field, and I'm going to name this Test Recording. I could also change the real name as well by clicking into the real field. I'll leave it just as the camera model for now. And I'll hide the clip list using the arrow in the lower left again. Now I'm ready to start recording. I'll move up to the top of the screen and click on the record button. It'll highlight red to show me that capturing is taking place. When I'm done recording, I just click that button again to stop the record. And I'll click the arrow in the lower left to reveal the clip list again. You can see this file that I've recorded, showing that it's recorded in the ProRes format. If I right-click, I can even open it right in Qt Player or as a source within ScopeBox. This is great for using a previous recording to compare against a new shot to make sure continuity is matched, for example. Those are the basics of using a recorder within ScopeBox, but there's a lot of advanced functionality available, so be sure to check the manual for full details.